I will bring to you music from the American Songbook. Now, there may be someone who doesn't know exactly what the American Songbook is, so I will tell you. The Great American Songbook is a collection of the most important and influential American popular songs and jazz standards from the early 20th century made by people like Irving Berlin, Richard Rodgers, Cole Porter, and of course, George Gershwin, Ira too. Much of the music was written for Broadway musical theater and Hollywood cinema and helped to elevate the singers of the day. So I'm going to begin with a song that was written by Ned Washington and Victor Young, and it was actually introduced by Susan Heywood in the film My Foolish Heart. And I'm going to play the title song, which is My Foolish Heart.
Battery 70%. Connected to Dotti's iPhone.
Chart. Thank you. It's one of my favorite songs. I'm going to continue with a piece that was from movie, a musical actually, called St. Louis Woman. It was written by Johnny Mercer and Harold Arlen, and it is called Come Rain, Come Shine. And I was very rude. I didn't introduce my band in the beginning. My band is one that you can hear but not see. They're camera shy. So. So now I'll continue with Come Rain, Come Shine.
One, two, three, four.
come rain or come shine. Today kind of looked like the rain could come, but it seems to be keeping itself away. So this particular piece, which was written for the movie Ziegfeld Follies. Now this kind of might be fun for those of you who are movie buffs and have been for a while maybe, and maybe these movies are familiar to you. So this was written by one of the Gershwins. It's Ira, not George, but Ira, who did mostly the lyrics for the tunes. And Ira Gershwin wrote it with Vernon Duke. They actually wrote it way back in 1935. It was kind of like the swing era there. And this is called I Can't Get Started.
One, two, three, four.
Thank you.
get started.
One, two, three.
Sorry about that, got a little ahead of me there. Ogden Nash and Kurt Weill played a tune called Speak Low, and that was actually written for a musical called One Touch of Venus. So this is Speak Low.
One, two, three, four.
We'll try that again.
One, two, one, two, three.
Speak low, speak low. I'd like to continue with a song entitled September Song. This was also written in the 30s, 1938 to be specific. And it was written by Maxwell Anderson and Kurt Weill. And it was written for a film entitled Damsel in Distress. Remember in the beginning, I said that the American Songbook had songs and American songs and jazz standards that were that were written for musical theater and film. And as you can see, each one that I happen to choose comes from either a film or from a musical. So this is September Song. Thank you. It's April, but that was September's song. So I'm going to make a little change here because I wanted you to know that there is a flute family. The flute that I just played was actually called the sea flute. And the one I'm going to play for you now, I'll have to stand back a bit. As you can see, it's much bigger than the one I just played. This is called a bass flute, and when I start playing, it's going to sound quite different from what I just played. This tune that I selected to play on this bass flute is entitled It Might As Well Be Spring, which was written by Richard Rodgers and Oscar Hammerstein. They wrote this in 1945, and that was written for a film also, and the film is entitled State Fair.
Thank you.
It might as well be spring on the bass flute. There are other flutes too, the piccolo, the alto flute, contrabass flute, double contrabass flute. I play in a group called the New York Jazz Flute, and we play all of them. So I'm going to end with a piece that's probably the favorite of many. It is a favorite of mine. It's something that's apropos for the month of February, not April, but that's okay. I'm going to play it anyway. And before I do, I want to say thank you so much for coming. It's been a pleasure playing for you. And the song that I'm going to play, as you might imagine, is written by Lawrence Hart and Richard Rodgers. They usually say Rodgers and Hart. It was written for the musical Babes in Arms in 1937. It's called My Funny Valentine.
Thank you.
My Funny Valentine. Thank you so much for being here. I enjoy playing for you and have a great rest of the day.